Hey, what's up guys, TechoSword here. Before anything else, I must apologize to every DigitalGo viewer that I promised back in December of the last year to try out 2 more SSD heat sinks for the DigitalGo. But due to logistical issues, they've taken much longer to arrive than anticipated. After ordering them 3 times from AliExpress, they finally arrived. So a short recap, in the previous video about cooling the DigitalGo original 2242 SSD, we compared the famous slim heat sink and saw how much it could lower temperature by about 15 degrees Celsius. But we are still aiming for a lower SSD temperature for the DigitalGo. For that reason, I've got 2 more copper heat sinks that come in 2 and 4mm in high, designed for the 2242 SSD NVMe size as well. And to make up for the long wait, I'm going to compare them in both the original back cover and the modded one. So without further delay, let's get started. A side tip, make sure to frequently clean your DigitalGo fan. Since I got it, I had to clean it 3 times already after finding quite some dust. You can use an air blower or clean it gently using a toothbrush as well. But before the cleaning, make sure to take off the battery cable. Let's remove now the existing slim heatsink. To be honest with you guys, I quite love this heatsink style. Like whenever I use it on any device, be it a laptop, a handheld, etc., it works like a charm. Its slim factor is almost guaranteed to fit 100% of times. But we are going to see if upgrading to a taller heatsink may help. So first of all, I'm going to get started first with the 2mm heatsink. And here it is. So we're going to peel this off. It also comes with a pre-applied 0.2mm thermal pad. Let's get everything back in now. Here I want to show you that after installing it, we can see it's not reaching the highest point yet. Therefore, I'm positive this cover will close just fine. And my assumption was on point. The cover closed totally fine, no issues at all with the clearance on the original cover. I also tightened all the screws and they all went in fine. Let's check now if it's going to work the same with the modded cover as well. And also on the modded cover, it can close just fine. So the 2mm heatsink can be mounted on both covers just fine with no clearance issues. Let's try now the 4mm heatsink. You can see the difference between them is quite evident. Frankly, after checking here, it seems that the heatsink is ever so slightly higher than all components here. I don't feel it's going to close. It might barely do, but it's not looking good so far. Let's try first with the modded cover. And it's not closing anymore. You can see on the bottom right angle, it's forcing itself back. Also on the original cover, it's not closing anymore with the 4mm heatsink. So we can conclude that the 4mm heatsink is not an option for the DigitalGo 2242 SSD. I'm going to store it for future use, who knows, I may need it soon enough. Now I would like to shift focus on upgrading the 2mm heatsink to see if we can fit in a higher thermal pad. I got this thermal pad kit from AliExpress that comes with 100 pads between 4 sizes, 0.2, 0.4, 1 and 1.5mm. I'll link it in the video description if you are interested in buying it as well. So to sort them, the white one is 0.2, pink is 0.4, orange is 1, and green is 1.5mm. We'll cut all the rod and get started with the thickest option. And now the thermal pad, it's not closing anymore on the original cover. Let's try the 1mm option. Again with the original cover, plus the 1mm thermal pad, it's not closing anymore. But on the modded cover, since it doesn't have parts that go all the way in, you just place it like this and just use the screws, so it has a bit more of clearance. So I was able to close it fine with the modded back cover. So since the 1mm didn't work with the original back cover, let's try the third option we have, that is a 0.4mm. On the modded cover, it's yet working fine. And also this time with the original cover, you may be able to close it with a 0.4 mm thermal pad. So now in total we've got 0.6 mm worth of thermal pad on the 2mm heatsink. Let's get on now to testing. I'm going to use crystal disk mark to test out temps. I also have set 30W TDP and maximum fan speed. Let's go for it. We can see that benchmark scores are pretty much equal for all setups. I haven't seen any significant difference. But the important part here is temperature. Localizing the thermal camera around the SSD area, on the original cover we've got a max of 47.4C on the slim heatsink. But with the 2mm heatsink, it actually increased rather than decreasing. With the heatsink and its pre-applied thermal pad maxing at 53.5C, and with the 0.4 mm thermal pad we add, it went down a bit to 49.4C. Instead, with the modded cover, it's a different story. You guys may remember from my review of this mod cover that actually worsens the internal SSD temp. So to recap, if you are planning to install your SSD inside and use that mod cover, it will just get worse than the original back cover. While if you install 2280 SSD that goes in the exterior part, it's good for that. Just if you place the SSD inside, it will be bad. Anyway, back to here, our best setup with the modded back cover is with the 2mm heatsink maxing at 56.4C without any thermal pad addition than its pre-applied one. Next is with the added 0.4 mm thermal pad at 57C. And since we were able to add the 1mm thermal pad for the modded cover, it got to 58.3. Finally, our worst setup for the modded cover is when we used the slim heatsink. So results are quite the opposite with the modded cover than the original one, where it actually gave us the best result in there. Checking SSD temps using its internal sensors, our best temps are with the original back cover with the slim heatsink installed, being at 70C for temp 1 and 94 for hotspot. Quite high already, but if we look down, we'll see we have a blazing hot temp maxing at 109C with the mod cover and the slim heatsink. Quite weird, as it's exactly the opposite with the original back cover. Then we see with the original cover and the 2mm heatsink, we got 80C for temp 1 and 104 for the hotspot. Adding the 0.4 thermal pad, it got to 74C for temp 1 and 98C for hotspot. Instead, for the modded cover plus the 2mm heatsink, we got 77 and 100C for hotspot. Adding the 0.4 thermal pad, 74 and 98. And since we were able to place the 1mm thermal pad fine on the modded cover, it improved much further, reaching 72 and 94C for hotspot, coming up all the way to claim the second place in this chart. So to conclude this, based on the result we've got, the 2mm heatsink didn't live up to my expectations in an improving temperature much more than the slim heatsink for Tradition Go. I'm not sure of the reason behind this, but it could be that with the taller heatsink that it started to prevent it from moving heat away. And due to clearance issues, we weren't able to install the 4mm heatsink as well. SSD temps on the Legion Go are pretty crazy and over the top. I don't feel happy at all whenever I see this rate indication constantly when installing games on Steam or playing for some time. But still, I don't regret the investment I made in getting the thermal pads package. First, they come in different sizes, being useful in more projects to come, and 100 of them for this price is a good deal. So I would recommend them in case you are looking for a good and compact multi thermal pad package. And that was it for this video. As ever, I hope it was useful. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to Techosaur to be updated on future Legion Go videos and to support the channel. I have quite many ideas to try out. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.